Before we get started, to reduce and avoid injury, you should check with your doctor before beginning any fitness program. By performing any fitness exercises, you are performing them at your own risk. Sooke Region Communities Health Network and Sooke Region Seniors Center Without Walls will not be held responsible or liable for any injury or harm you sustained as a result of participating in our online fitness or information shared on our Zoom account, website, or social media channels.
Hello, and welcome to week 3 of the Sooke Region Communities Health Network's Falls Prevention Program. This week, we'll talk about how you can adapt your environment to reduce your fall risk. Then we'll do some exercises for flexibility, balance, and strength.
Where do falls happen? The majority of falls happen in and around your home. It helps to think about where you've already experienced a fall and what you can do to make that location safer so you don't fall again. What could have prevented the fall? Maybe you tripped on a rug. Maybe if there was a grab bar nearby, you wouldn't have fallen. Think about that, how you can make your environment safer. What have you been able to change so that the fall doesn't happen again? It's important to think about whether you've put additional supports in your home and environment, like railings, non-skid surfacing, even extra lighting in a place that it's not easy to see where your feet go. If you fall outdoors, it might be harder to get help. It's a good idea to carry a phone, have someone with you, or tell someone where and what you're doing. You could also carry a whistle or a car key fob to attract attention if something happens and you need assistance. Just make sure if you do that, that your neighbors know that if they hear a car alarm, it might be you asking for help. What about public places? What are the fall hazards you've experienced in the community? How can you avoid them? Safe stairs. As we age, stairs can become a significant obstacle. Have you avoided or been unable to attend an activity or event because of stairs? We have a little diagram here that shows the optimum rise and run for stairs to help you to keep from falling. It's also a good idea to take a look at the railings. Support is improved when the railing extends for 12 inches beyond the first and the last step. You need significant shoulder flexibility to use a short railing for those 2 steps. This is clearly a fall hazard. So check your railings. Outdoor risk factors. Stairs. Make sure, again, that the stairs have appropriate spacing, handrails, and landings or ramps. Pathways, sidewalks, and walking surfaces. Make sure they are well lit, no debris, even surfaces, concrete, gravel, packed trails, wood chip paths. Lighting. Well lit. Want to avoid deep shadows or heavily angled lighting. Public spaces. You want to be aware of curbs and ramps, adequate lighting, clear entrances, and rest areas. Pathways and walkways represent different fall risks depending on the individual. Walkers may have more difficulty with some surfaces. Canes can catch on obstacles close to the path. Gravel that's spread over the top of pavement or sidewalks can be very slippery. Next week, we'll be looking at equipment, which addresses things that can bring into daily life either personally, like canes, walkers, sock pulls, or the environment, like motion sensor lighting, toilet seat risers, and bed rails. Hello, and welcome to the exercise program for week 3. It's pretty similar to the exercise program in week 2, but we've added a few things. So first, make sure you're set up on your nice stable chair with your comfortable clothes, water nearby, maybe your walker close by if you might need it for standing and sitting. And first, just close your eyes and take a moment to check in. Notice how you're feeling today, in this very moment. Are there any places of tension? Any places that are painful or uncomfortable? Any places that feel open and ready to move? How is your breath flowing? How do you feel in your spirit, in your emotions? No need to change anything. Just checking in. And just as we did last week, let's begin with 3 deep breaths. And I'll leave it up to you. You can open your eyes or close your eyes, whatever feels better. So exhale to begin. Take a deep breath in through the nose. And then exhale through open lips. Good. This time as you inhale, feel like you're pressing down with your sitting bones and reaching the crown of your head up so you get even taller. And then as you exhale, keep that height. And one more time, inhaling, expanding yourself into the space around you. And then exhaling, feeling your sitting bones rooting into the chair, your feet rooting into the earth. Beautiful. Let's do some standing and sitting to get ourselves moving. So lean forward, press your weight into your feet, use your walker if you need it, or press your hands into your thighs and come up. You could also do this with your arms crossed over your chest, if that's comfortable for you. Find the way that feels better in your body. And another thing is, if this is difficult for you, you could sit on a slightly higher chair so you didn't have as much movement to do. And let's just do one more. Perfect. Good. Take a little breather. Next is the pelvic rock. So first rolling onto the backs of the sitting bones and then rocking forward onto the fronts of them. If you'd like this week, you can touch your knees with your hands, which sort of makes this into a mini cat-cow is what we call this in yoga. Yeah, so we're rounding our back towards the back of the chair and then arching the back a little bit. Yeah, so that's taking that basic pelvic rock, and just taking it a little bit higher up in the spine. Just really getting that spine flexing and extending. Nice. Okay. Now let's roll our shoulders. So they go forward, up, back, and down. Let's just roll them about 5 times. If there are any places that are a little sticky, maybe take a little extra time there. Nice. And then let's go in the other direction. Just let your arms go along for the ride. Just working out all that tension in the shoulders. Beautiful. Now let's sparkle our hands. Just bring them up and open them, close them really quickly. Yeah, just to keep our hands nice and active and mobile. Keep the joints lubricated. And then just do a little stretch. You could even take a moment to just give yourself a little mini hand massage. Always a nice thing to do. And then just opening up the palm of the hand, opening up the fingers. stretching it through the front of the forearm. Feels so good. And then let's do the same with the other hand. You give it a little mini massage. If there's some places that are feeling like they need a little extra love, just dig in there. And then spread the fingers, open up the palm. And if you'd like, gradually take it more higher up into the forearm. Great. Okay. Now we'll do our side stretch, same as the other day. You can rest your hand on the edge of the chair if you'd like. Reach way up and over. Put your head in a place that it feels comfortable. As you're stretching the side of your body, make sure you're still anchoring through your feet. Still keeping them nice and pressing into the floor. Up and over. And then the other side. We're just going to do one in each direction today. But remember, you can always hit that pause button if this feels really good to you and you want to do like 10. Go right ahead. It's your program. Next, we're coming into our seated march. So we're grounding one foot and lifting the other. If you'd like, you can add your arms. Up to you. Notice what your core is doing. Do you feel your core muscles activating just a little bit here? Checking in with your breath, noticing how it's moving. Remember, if it starts going too fast, always can take a little rest. Always take a little breather whenever you need. Excellent job. Moving on to waking up the feet. We'll just take a look at your feet and just play with rolling them a little bit side to side, off to the edge of one and the edge of the other. And we're going to add something here today. I just want to add on, you might need to bring your feet a little closer to you. Press down with the balls of the feet and lift the heels up. Do this standing. It's really nice to do it sitting first. It really helps you to get the sense of how the feet move. And this is really great for our calf muscles. It's really important to keep the feet and the ankles capable and mobile. Okay, and now we're going to lift the front of the foot. You might find it helps to take the feet a little further forward and just alternate. Sometimes if they're really close to you, it's hard to get any movement. That's different from person to person. And so just lifting one foot and then the other. That's great. This is great because it really strengthens up the front of the shin. We don't do this action very often. It's really helpful. Awesome. Moving on to our seated hamstring stretch. So you're just going to extend one leg forward, pull the toes back, sit up nice and tall, and just roll forward on the front edges of the sitting bones so that you can stretch the back of the thigh. For some people, you might feel it more in the calf than the thigh. That's okay. You can adjust that by bending and straightening the leg a little bit. And then let's change sides. Just bring that foot back, plant it, extend the other leg forward, sit up really tall, and then lean forward over that leg. It doesn't have to be a lot of movement, just the fact that you feel those tissues on the back side of the leg stretching gently. This is great because it stretches the whole back side of the body, the fascia on the whole back side of the body. Come back up again. And now let's point and flex the ankle. So just extend one leg forward. Could be higher or lower, whatever works best on your body. And just point and flex that foot a few times. See if you can extend it as much as possible and pull the toes back as much as possible. So you're getting full range of motion in that ankle joint. And plant it down. Do the same thing with the other foot. It's really important to keep our ankles strong. That's like our first connection to the floor, our feet. And plant that foot down. We're going to add a little foot rotation here. just to really get the strength and the mobility into the ankle. So just rolling the foot around in one direction and in the other, almost as if you had a pencil on the end of your toes and you were drawing a circle with your toes. The same thing on the other side. You could go slow or fast. You could always pause and take a little more time. And when you're finished, you might want to give your quadriceps a little jiggle and release any tension there. And now our figure four stretch, which is a really nice hip opener. Just extend one leg and cross the other ankle over top. At right here, you can lift up tall and lean forward. If you don't get much of a stretch there, you could bring this foot a little higher. It's also an option to bend the underneath leg. And then you're just leaning forward, looking for a really gentle opening sensation in the hip of the upper leg. Take some full, deep breaths here. And then when you're ready, switching sides. Take it low if you'd like, or maybe a little higher. Put this foot wherever it feels comfortable, and then lean forward. If you're prone to lower back pain, this can be a really great exercise for opening up the muscles in the hips and easing the pain in the lower back. And it's great because you can do it anywhere. All right, coming back to sitting. Now for our next section, we're going to introduce a prop. You can use a yoga block if you happen to have such a thing. Pilates ball, mine is deflated, but that works too. Or some kind of cushion that you just happen to have around your house. So what I'd like you to do is make sure that your feet are parallel. I often imagine a line from the second toe to the center of the heel. And then we're going to squeeze that something between our thighs. So it should be such that your knees are in front of your hips. So whatever, usually about this wide, but it depends on the width of your hips, what feels comfortable, you'll know. So the reason I want to do this is I really want to connect our feet to our core. So can you feel if you squeeze that block a little bit, or that cushion, or that ball, you can root down through the base of your big toes, through the inner edge of your foot, and connect all the way up into your core. So just see if you can feel that. And then we're going to bring our palms together. And I'd like to do just a little shoulder stabilizing, because part of the thing that we need when we're avoiding falls is strength through our arms and our shoulders. So just bring your hands together, pull the tips of your shoulder blades down your back, and then gently let your hands float up and gather your elbows together. Now they might touch, they might just come part way. It doesn't really matter. What matters is that you feel your shoulder blades connecting to the backside of your body. You can feel your shoulder blades rooting onto your rib cage. So this is a really great exercise to do for yourself. This is especially important if you tend to use a mobility aid like a walker or walking sticks. Now you want your shoulders to really be able to support you. Now we're going to separate the elbows again, bring the palms together, and do a little wrist stretch. So keep your gaze straight ahead, keep your chest straight ahead, and just move your hands to one side. You should feel a little stretch in the wrist of the side that you're moving towards. And it helps to press a little bit more firmly with the fingers, especially with the roots of the fingers. Nice. Now let's take it over to the other side. Good. Just take a few deep breaths there. Remember always to check in with your breath. Nice. Okay, bring this back to center. Let's just give them a little relax. And now we're going to move one hip back. I'm just going to step that hip back a little bit, but I'm still squeezing my stuff here, my block or my bolster. Bring your hands together And now twist from your belly towards the back of the chair. You can keep your hands here, or you could just loop one arm over the back of the chair and put the other one on the side knee. You don't want to twist too hard or too far. You're going to feel that the twist begins at the belly and then spirals up the spine, right out the top of the head. And then come back to center. Let's bring our hands together to twist again. So you're going to step that hip back to its spot, and then you're going to move the other one back. This is important because we don't want to put any twist in the back of the pelvis. We don't want to torque our sacroiliac joint. Often that's the roots of back pain. So we're avoiding that. Twist gently from your belly, looking over your shoulder, looping that arm over the back of the chair, the other hand on the side of the knee. Then take some nice deep breaths here. Keep squeezing your thighs. Yeah? So you keep feeling that rooting action from the feet all the way up to your core. Keep checking in with the breath. And come back to center. Then bring the palms of the hands together one more time. Interlace the fingers, reverse them, and then press them forward. Good. Spreading the hands wide, so you're really opening them up, stretching them. I'd like you to actually take a look also at your elbows. So make sure you've brought them all the way to straight, that the eyes of the elbows are looking at each other. And then root those shoulder blades down onto the back. And so you really feel their connection to the ribs. Awesome. Okay, let's give that a little bit of a wiggle. Let's set that block aside. And we're just going to do a little seated reach. Yeah, so just reaching across your body. Now, since we practiced straightening our elbows a minute ago, you can make sure here that you get your elbows straight. Yeah, and then let's reach it up a little bit on an angle. Really opening up the side body. And then let's take it overhead. Good. If you need a little help, you can take your hand onto your chair, but it's also really great for your core to move here, to tip yourself a little bit extra so you get a little bit of core work. All right, and speaking of which, our last thing, our last seated is a core tilt. So I invite you to just bring your hands across your body, lean forward a little bit, you know how you're rolling forward onto the fronts of the sitting bones, but now we're taking the whole body forward. And then you're going to lean back onto the backs of the sitting bones. And then just tipping forward and back, taking the weight into the feet, and then taking the weight back. Just close your eyes for a moment. Just notice if you feel this in your core. And you feel those abdominal muscles activating, getting stronger. You also feel the action of the feet rooting into the earth. Now we're going to move on to a few standing exercises. First, come to a nice stand. You want to move your chair so it's turning sideways. It definitely needs to be stable. So if you've got a slippery floor like I do, you might want to stick some kind of mat or something underneath it just so that you know that your chair is stable and it's not going to go sliding out from underneath you. We're going to do a little squat. So you want to start with your feet about shoulder width apart, turn them out a little bit, and let's do this facing our chair. So you can make this squat as small or as big as you're capable of. If you've got really sensitive knees, this might be a really tiny squat. Yeah. And also, if you used to do 50 squats when you were 20, it's not going to be the same. You might be doing a few less. However, another thing to know is that doing this motion, this activity that strengthens the quads and the glutes, is not only good for our fall prevention, it's also really helpful for keeping our brains in gear. So just resting your hands on the back of your chair, keep your heart lifted, put your weight in, feel your weight in your feet, take a deep breath in, and then as you exhale, fold at the front of the hip. Let the knees slide down over the feet. And let's just make it small, the first one. push the feet into the floor to come up. And then let's repeat that. Bent. And come back. Good. Keep your abdominal muscles engaged so you're really supporting your lower back with your core. Be very conscientious about any knee pain. We really want to take care of our knees. We only have two. Good. And just notice if you feel the muscles in the backs of your legs working. Notice how your breath is moving. Let's do three more without me talking at all so you can really pay attention. Beautiful. Hopefully your legs feel great. Now we're just going to do some little lunges. Turn again towards your chair. Just step one foot back. Feet are in line with your hips. So not like you're standing on a tightrope, but like you're standing on the train tracks. And then we're just going to bend the front knee and then straighten again. I'm going to move a little closer to my chair. Might find you have to adjust a little. We want to keep this leg moving, so we're creating some strength there. You also might get a little bit of a stretch in that back calf. Good. And then we'll switch sides. Step that foot forward, the other one back. It makes a big difference to have these feet parallel, especially the back one. Yeah. And then just bend and straighten a few times. Keep your chest lifted. Keep checking in with your breath. Nicely done. Excellent work, everyone.
Well done. Thank you for joining us for week 3 of the Souk Region Communities Health Network's Falls Prevention Program. Next week, we'll talk about reducing fall risk through changes to supportive equipment, clothing, and footwear, followed by exercises for balance, strength, and agility.